Good morning, students. In the previous video, we have solved some numerical problems, and before that, we studied resistors connected in series. Now, today we will learn another combination, that is resistors in parallel combination. When do you say that resistors are in parallel? Let us again take the same three resistors R1, R2, R3, and how they are connected in parallel. Let us suppose this is one point X. From this point, three resistors are connected. One between point X and Y. Suppose this is a R1 resistance, and this is R2 resistance, and this is R3 of different values. So if they are connected in this way, all the right terminals of the resistors are taken to one point and all the left terminals are taken to another common point. So such a combination is called as parallel combination. When this is taken in a circuit, suppose this is taken in a circuit consisting of a battery. This is a battery with a key. And then to read the current, an ammeter is taken, and to this point this ammeter is connected, so that the longer line is positive terminal, the shorter line is negative terminal. So combination of cells gives us battery. Suppose this battery is providing a voltage of V. When we close the key, it provides voltage of potential difference of V volts. So suddenly when you close the key, the current, let I be the current flowing through. If I is the current flowing through, then you see this same current enters here. After reaching point X, the current I finds three branches. So let I1 be the current through R1. The current flowing through R1 is I1, current flowing through R2 be I2, and current flowing through R3, resistance R3 be I3, such that all these three currents I1, I2, I3, they again combine to form current I here. Same current flows. So what do you see here? If some fixed number of charges are flowing, say 100 charges are flowing, then out of these 100, some charges are flowing through R1 according to the value of R1, some charges will be flowing through R2, and some charges will be remaining charges will be flowing through R3. Means if I is the current, then that current will be divided into I1, I2, and I3, so that the total current I becomes equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. If you take a voltmeter and connect it here, the voltage that is given across XY will be same as voltage across R1, voltage across R2, voltage across R3. V is representing the voltmeter. The voltmeter is always connected in parallel. Remember, voltmeter is a device which is used to measure potential difference, and this voltmeter is always connected in parallel, so that it shows us how much is the potential difference across that resistor or across that wire. And ammeter is always connected in series. Look at this. Ammeter is always connected in series with the circuit. Ammeter should be always taken in series, always connected in series in the circuit. Circuit means circuit, and a voltmeter should be in parallel. What I mean to say here is, when the resistors are connected in this fashion, in parallel, all the right terminals are taken to one point, all the left terminals are taken to another common point, and when these common points are connected to the battery with the help of key, then these resistors are connected in parallel combination. Now, when it is in parallel combination, the current I flowing through this is divided into branches. I1 through R1, I2 through R2, I3 through R3. Here, current, main current I becomes equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3, where I1, I2, I3 are the currents through R1, through R2, through R3 respectively. But potential difference remains the same. V remains same because R1 is connected across XY, R2 is also connected across XY, R3 is also connected across XY. So if you connect voltmeter across XY, the voltmeter reading will be same. If you connect it across R1, voltmeter reading will be same. If you connect it across R2, voltmeter reading will be same. If you connect it across R3, because they are connected to common terminals. So potential difference across XY is same as potential difference across R1, is same as potential difference across R2, is same as potential difference across R3. So potential difference V remains the same through all three branches. That is, V across XY, V across X and Y is same as V across R1, same as V across R2, same as V across R3. Now, the main potential difference is V. If you take this entire branch as one, if R1, R2, R3 which are taken in parallel, if you think, assume that the entire total resistance of these R1, R2, R3 is RP. If RP is the total resistance of the combination, total resistance of the combination, then using Ohm's law, I can write V equal to RPI. V equal to RPI, where I is the main current, that is flowing through the circuit. I is the main current flowing through the circuit, which will be measured by ammeter. Therefore, RP is equal to V by I. Similarly, I can find out what is the value of R1. What is the value of R1? What is the value of R2? What is the value of R3? Or better to find out what is the value of current I1, I2, I3 using Ohm's law. So using this, this implies I can write I is equal to V by R3. I is equal to V by R3. Now, in the same way, what is I1? Similarly, I1 you can written as, using Ohm's law, V by R1, V by R1, where I1 is equivalent to resistance R1. Similarly, what is I2? I2 equal to V by
R2, because potential difference remains same, so same V will be taken. I2 equal to V by R2, and I3 equal to V by R3. So remember, when the resistors are connected in parallel, the potential difference remains same. This is to be remembered. Potential difference remains same. Current is divided into three branches, I1, I2 and I3. So sum of the currents is equal to main current. Whereas in case of series, it is reversed. In case of series, the current through all the resistors will be same when they are in series. Same current flows through R1, R2, R3 connected in series. But potential difference is divided as V1, V2 and V3. So V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3 in case of series. So that is just the reverse. So in case of parallel combination, V remains constant. Current I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3, that is branch currents. So now you substitute these values, substituting I1, I2 and I3 in this main equation, we are going to get an interesting result. Okay, call this equation as 1, I equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3 as equation number 1. Substituting the values of I1, I2, I3 in equation 1. Substituting I1, I2 and I3 in equation 1. What do we get? I is equal to, look at this, V by R1. Even I can be also substituted. We have found out what is I. I is V by RP. V by RP. That is left hand side. I is equal to V by RP. Is equal to. I1 is V by R1. I2 is V by R2. And I3 is V by R3. Now V is common throughout. Take out V common. So V cancels. Since V is common, so if you take V common here, becomes 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. So V cancels, therefore we get 1 by RP becomes equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. So this is the equation for the total effective combination, total effective resistance, when the resistors are connected in parallel. So 1 by RP equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Using this, one can find out RP value. So what is 1 by RP? Reciprocal. Therefore, reciprocal of effective resistance, reciprocal of effective resistance in parallel combination is equal to sum of reciprocals of the individual resistors. Sum of the reciprocals of individual resistances of the resistors. If only two are there, if only R1 and R2 are there, suppose only R1 and R2 are there, in parallel combination, then what is effective total resistance? 1 by R is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. If only R1 and R2 are in parallel,
If R, R1 and R2 are in parallel, then 1 by R is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. We want to find out what is R. Therefore, if you simplify this, this will become in the denominator R1 plus R2, and in the numerator it becomes R2 R1 or R1 R2 R1 R2. Therefore, what will be the value of R? R becomes equal to R1 plus R2 divided by R1 R2. So this is easy to remember. If the only two resistors are in parallel, then effective resistance of these two resistors in parallel is equal to R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. I think I have written the reverse. Okay, this is not the correct one. In the denominator we will get R1 R2. Here you get R1 plus R2. But when you take the inverse of this, so inverse of this if you take, then we get resistance in parallel is equal to R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. You must remember this, it will be helpful while solving the numerical problems. Therefore, reciprocal of effective resistance, reciprocal of effective resistance in parallel combination is equal to sum of the reciprocals of the individual resistances of the resistance. This is how we have to remember. In case of series, it was simple. Total effective resistance in case when the resistors are in series, R is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. That is when it is in series. Here it is in parallel. So in parallel, remember, potential difference V remains constant and current I becomes equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3 according to the values of R1, R2, R3 branch currents. Now one more thing you please remember, the voltmeter must be always connected in parallel, which enables us to read the potential difference. Therefore it should be connected in parallel. It will be having a very high resistance, so it will be able to read the, it will be able to take very less amount of current. So with the help of less amount of current, which is negligible, it will be able to read the potential difference in volts. Whereas the ammeter should be always connected in series. Why should it be connected in series? The purpose of ammeter is to read the current. It is to read the entire current. Therefore, ammeter should be connected in series. The ammeter is having very less resistance. The ammeter is having very less resistance. So it allows the entire current to flow. I think the point is clear. So if voltmeter is connected in the series, then it will not be able to read the current. It will be giving us error. So if main current flows through voltmeter, there is a chance that voltmeter resistor will be spoiled. Voltmeter coil will be spoiled, it will be burnt. Okay. The purpose of voltmeter is to measure the potential difference across the points. Therefore, voltmeter must be always connected in parallel. Ammeter should be always connected in series. The purpose is to read the entire current flowing through the circuit. Therefore, it should be connected in series. Now, let us solve some simple problems. Let us look at this problem. Same circuit diagram is taken. In the same circuit diagram, if you just look at it, the same circuit diagram, the resistances are given. R1 is equal to 5 ohm, R2 is equal to 10 ohm, and R3 is equal to 30 ohm. If these are the three resistances and voltage supplied by the battery is 12 volts, battery supplies a voltage of 12 volts, you are asked to calculate current through each resistor. What is the current through R1? What is the current through R2? What is the current through R3? I1, I2, I3. Second one is total current in the circuit, and third one is total resistance of the circuit. So problem is simple if you have followed the theory. Now first let us calculate current through each resistor. Current through R1. Current through R1 is given by I1. Using Ohm's law, I1 is equal to V by R1. V is same as I told you. Potential difference remains same. 12 volts. Here V is 12 volts. So 12 divided by R1. R1 is equal 5 ohm. So it becomes 5 to the 10, 5 to the, so it becomes 2.4 amperes. So if you connect this ammeter here, it will show 2.4 ampere of current. Now current through R2. Current through R2. I2 is equal to. Same way V by R2. V by R2. 12 divided by R2 is 10 ohm. So it becomes 12 divided by 10. So it becomes 1.2 ampere. 1.2 ampere. Now similarly current through R3. Current through R3. I3 equal to V by R3. V by R3 implies same 12 volts divided by R3. R3 here is 30 ohm. So if you cancel it with 6, 6 2s are 6 5s are 2 by 5. 6 2s are 6 5s are 2 by 5. So it becomes 0.4 ampere. Now you can calculate total current. Therefore, now total current. First one is over now. This is first problem. Second one. Therefore, second one, total current, total current I becomes equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. So if you add them, it comes out to be 5 plus, sorry, the currents are 2.4, just add them, 2.4 plus 1.2 plus 0.4, 2.4 plus 1.2 plus 0.4. If you add this, 4 plus 2 plus 6, it becomes 10. So 0 carry 1. So it becomes 4.0 ampere. That is, total current becomes 4 amperes. So second problem is over. First problem is over. Second problem is over. Now the third one is total resistance. Now resistance are in parallel. Now total resistance. Third one. Total resistance or effective resistance, since they are in 3, therefore 1 by R is equal to 1 by RP. You are asked to calculate RP. 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. So 1 by R1, 1 by 5 plus 1 by R2, 1 by 10 plus 1 by 30. So LCM is 30. So it becomes 5 6 is 10 3 is 30 1 is 6 plus 3 plus 1 10. 6 plus 3 plus 1 it becomes 10. So 10 by 30 implies 1 by 3. Therefore 1 by RP equal to 1 by 3. This implies RP is equal to reciprocal of 3 ohm. So total resistance thus becomes this entire box, if you take it as entire as a single resistance, it acts as a just 3 ohm. So 3 ohm resistance. So if you calculate the total resistance when they are in parallel, the total resistance of parallel combination will be least than the lesser one. Least than the lesser one. The lesser one is 5 ohm. 10 ohm, 30 ohm. Out of these 3, 5 ohm is the least one. The parallel combination effective resistance will be less than the least one. You can say less than the least one. So 3 ohm is quite less than 5 ohm.
So if whatever you want to have minimum resistance to be obtained, then the resistors must be connected in parallel. I think you got the point. We'll solve more and more problems in the next session. So please solve the problems, whatever problem we have solved yesterday. Okay. And in the examination, as I told you, the topic will be both light as well as electricity. In the electricity, it will be asked up to resistivity, up to what are the factors on which the resistance depends. What are the factors on which the resistance depends? Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye.